My first foray into the animal form was 25 years ago when I made a range of papier-mâché life-sized animals. I made a giraffe, I made a number of English bulls, and a couple of carousel horses. And I would make the initial wood mold, and from there, we would make the papier-mâché form, which would be maybe 7 to 10 layers of newspaper pasted on the wooden form. And this was the first time I came face to face with the necessity to have a very good knowledge and grounding in the structure of the animal that I was making. Above all else, I really try to portray movement in my sculptures. And one way of achieving this is to depict two subjects interacting with each other, like the sculpture of the two rutting stags fighting for dominance. The underlying element of survival really adds drama to the piece. I had an unconventional childhood, which in retrospect is tailor-made for what I am doing now. My parents are antique dealers, and I spent the longer part of my childhood moving from country to country. They would uproot us as a family and move us to the location of the current deal, and which was fantastic for us because we not only got to learn about a new culture, but we also got to appreciate a different set or sphere of the artwork. As a result of my exposure to antiques from my very early childhood, it's in my core to see the potential in what other people might term of as waste or discarded material. And this has been a recurrent theme during my working life. I've always been drawn to reusing material which other people throw away. I find myself drawn to those vital moments in the life of the animals that I am creating. For example, 5 salmon jumping up a waterfall, fighting their way back to their spawning grounds. Motion and survival are often linked, and I focus on this element to breathe life into my sculptures. I've collected old wood for more than 20 years and have amassed a sizable collection during that time of driftwood pieces. And it's the different forms of driftwood that initially led me to my first sculpture. Once I have an idea of a sculpture, I will spend a long time studying the animal, not just its anatomy and form, but also its habitat and its life, before focusing on one specific movement or stage in its life cycle. One of the specific challenges in creating my driftwood sculptures is selecting and visualizing that particular piece, that particular part of a piece of driftwood that might best complement the sculpture I'm making. For example, this piece here would give me a good eye. If you can focus on this part, if you can focus on this part here, you can see the upper eye, and then also a bit of the form of the head. I would have to chop the piece of driftwood here, and I would also have to add in another piece underneath it to give the lower eye, to give a softer appearance to the overall eye structure. But I think the combination of these two pieces worked the right way might be the basis of a good head of a stag. Before embarking on the full-sized, I'll first of all make a smaller scale version, just to get a better understanding of the subject and also to see the further possibilities of that particular form. Making a life-size sculpture is a long, drawn-out process. From my initial sketches to the final pattern, through to the stainless steel frame, and then finally to the assembly of the driftwood can take more than a couple of thousand hours. What I find really satisfying about my work is being able to take something which is dead and inanimate, and being able to transform it into something which is vital, which has movement and life.